Hello and welcome to Art Snacks. Today, our lesson is going to be about the weaver in colonial America and what they did. This was a historic trade. People were weaving for a very long time. Now, recent evidence suggests that there weren't very many weavers in colonial America, that they ordered their fabric from England and China and India. But the weavers that were there used fabric or used thread or used fibers that were imported largely from England and China and India, nevertheless. And when they would weave on a loom. And we're going to just draw sort of parts of what a loom would look like. And again, we're going to make fast lines here. Now the weaver would sit on a stool in this area, right in front of this large loom. This was exacting work. And a person who likes detail or a perfectionist might really enjoy being a weaver. And they would work with the warp and the woof. Sounds funny, of threads. And so they would set up their loom in a way so they had long fibers going this direction. They would then weave in through here a secondary fiber of some sort. It could be thicker or larger or a different color. But as they begin to weave this through, each one of these would change. One would go over, the next one would go under, the next one would go over, the next one would go under, and so forth. And that sort of established a pattern. And your jeans are made this way, even today. And it makes cloth stronger. And they would just start weaving. And as they wove, they would pull those tighter and tighter until the thread. There's something called the thread count. Is how many of these per square inch? How many? And if there were like twice as many of these and twice as many of these, you had a higher thread count. And these were thicker fabrics. And today, if you buy a cheap T-shirt and it feels really thin, then it's got a very small thread count. Okay, so from here out, this is part of the product that is beginning to become finished here. So let's say this is a rug or some item. And so as these things go together in a tight way, they start to form what looks like at the end of the day, a blanket or a rug or whatever those things are. Okay, so the loom goes up like this. And depending on how long you needed this to be, these would be longer or shorter. And you would bring in with a little needle thread on it. You would stitch that in between, pull that tight, and just keep going. So the weaver was very important. Now, they didn't always work with white thread, of course, and using cotton and using linen and some of the natural fibers. But they would use color. And to use color, they would provide... they would dye these things using some of the natural dyes, and some of these dyes were gotten from interesting places. For instance, the color red was gotten from a cochineal. It's an insect called a cochineal from South America that made the color red, and it took 70,000 of these bugs to make 1 pound of red dye that could turn anything red, from leather to cloth. And they also used it in paints and textiles. And they'd get the color brown from walnuts. They would get the color blue from indigo from South Carolina or Spain or South America. Purple they would get from the Spanish logwood tree. And they'd get yellow from turmeric, which is a spice from India, and orange from the root of the madder plant. The hardest fabric to dye was wool, because it didn't absorb the dye like it might. So like cotton might absorb it into the fiber, it would sit on the outside of the fiber of wool, and sometimes it was hard to hard to dye those things, hard to dye linen for that reason. So anyway, that's a little bit about the tailor in colonial America. See you next time.